One of the fundamental laws of physics, set forth by Einstein in the early 1900s, is that nothing in the universe can travel faster than the speed of light. Massless particles, such as photons, which are little units of light packets, travel at that threshold speed. But everything that has mass necessarily must be slower, or it would take an infinite amount of energy to accelerate a particle to that barrier speed, which is, of course, not physical. But since the development of quantum mechanics in the 1920s, people have been trying to cheat this fundamental law and figure out how to use quantum entanglement to send information faster than the speed of light. But this is not possible, and every single scheme that people have dreamt up to figure out how to do this has failed and necessarily will fail. And I will explain why. So for a little bit of background, in quantum mechanics, we have this idea of entanglement. So let's just say, in this case, we're entangling two qubits, two quantum bits together. And entanglement means that these quantum bits have become correlated far more than classical physics can explain. So for instance, if I have two entangled qubits, and they're entangled in such a way that every single time I measure this one to be in state zero, this one instantaneously and necessarily will be found to be in state one. And it doesn't matter how far apart my qubits are either. So say if I send one with my friend to the end of the world or the end of the universe, and I stay where I'm standing, and our particles are entangled with one another. When I measure mine, I find it to be in state zero or state one. I know instantaneously that my friend's qubit is going to be in the exact opposite state. And so you can sort of see here, since it is an instantaneous collapse of the entanglement, how one would be able to send information or some sort of signal faster than the speed of light naively. But this is not the case, because quantum mechanics is inherently random. Every single time I measure my qubit, I have a 50% chance of finding it to be in zero and a 50% chance of finding it to be in state one. There's no way for me to send my friend his qubit or her qubit and have it be in a particular state that I can know, because quantum mechanics dictates that this randomness is fundamental. I can't just send him a known chain of objects and have it be three zeros or three ones in a row. Every single measurement is inherently random, so you can't send information this way. It would be no faster than me being able to call my friend and telling them what state I found my qubit to be in. No information can ever be transferred faster than the speed of light, because information is physical. Only things that are non-physical and not mass, like shadows, can travel faster than the speed of light. And we know this for a fact. This isn't just like scientists used to say, we'll never be able to, you know, cross the barrier of the speed of sound. We did do that. The speed of light is a fundamental barrier of the universe that we cannot accelerate to and we cannot cross, or we would completely destroy the laws of causality, of cause and effect. And that, and because information is physical, is the reason why no information can be sent using entanglement or any other means to send information faster than the speed of light.